Madam, Madam, I bring to your attention something which concerns the honor and prestige of MPs and of the Indian Parliament. The Supreme Court on Wednesday issued a notice to the central government and to the Election Commission on a petition moved by an NGO, Lok Prahari, as to why the cost of MPs, perks and pensions should be borne by the taxpayers. As you know, madam, the MPs' allowances and pension is covered by an act in 1954, which was amended in 2006. By issuing and accepting a notice on MPs' perks and pensions, the Supreme Court is actually transgressing into the area of parliamentary privileges and their rights. We are not asking why the Supreme Court judges are being paid pension, but why should the Supreme Court ask why MPs are being paid pension? This is not the first example of the Supreme Court interfering into the affairs of Parliament. You are the custodian of our rights in Parliament. I bring to your notice and through you that of the government that such transgressions by the Supreme Court in the exclusive areas of MPs' privileges, perks and pensions, which are part of the law of the land, should not be allowed. And as a house, as a whole,
ex-MPs are also provided.
Now that is why they are asking whether why ex-MPs are provided pension, whereas it is guaranteed by law. Madam, we should take a stand as a whole in this house against this Supreme Court attitude. Sir.